Hello children, how are you? I hope all of you are safe and fine at home. Today our topic is sentence. In last grammar class, I taught you about parts of sentence and its parts. Today I will teach you kinds of sentences. There are four kinds of sentences. Declarative or assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. There are four kinds of sentences: declarative or assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. Each kind of sentence has its own closing punctuation. Own closing punctuation means full stop at the end of declarative or imperative, question mark at the end of interrogative, and exclamation mark at the end of exclamatory sentence. And it is used for a specific form of communication. Sentence is used for a specific form of communication. Now let us learn what is declarative or assertive sentences. Declarative sentences make a statement or declare something. Declarative sentences make a statement, or we can say a sentence which declares or asserts something is called declarative sentence. These always end with a full stop. Declarative sentences end with a full stop. Declarative sentence can be affirmative or negative. Affirmative means the sentence which gives positive sense. Affirmative means the sentence which gives positive sense, and negative sentence gives negative sense. Here, for example, you see, I love to eat mangoes. It is giving positive sense, so this is an affirmative sentence. The cat did not chase the mouse. It is giving negative sense, so it is a negative sentence. A sentence in the present tense changes into negative with the use of do not and does not before the main verb. I do not read science fiction. My cat does not like milk. I is first person, so do has been used. And my cat is third person, so does has been used. In present tense, in simple present tense, do or does is used before not. In the past tense changes into negative with the use of did not before the main verb. But when we use in simple past tense, then it is used did not. Marlon did not play his best yesterday. He did not break the jar. Here did not, because the sentence is in simple past tense. Now interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences are used to ask a question. Interrogative sentences are used to ask question. Or we can say, the sentence which is used to ask question is called interrogative sentence. These end with a question mark. Interrogative sentences end with a question mark. Interrogative sentences are of two kinds: yes no question and WH word question. Yes no question begins with an auxiliary verb or helping verb, and WH word question begins with a WH word itself. For example, do you like reading books? Here do is auxiliary verb. The yes no question begins with do. Here you are seeing that yes no question begins with do. The above sentence begins with an auxiliary verb do and can be answered in yes or no. What are you doing? The above sentence begins with a WH question word what and cannot be answered in yes no. A full statement has to be given as its answer. WH word question's answer should be in a full statement. WH word question's answer should be in a full statement. Remember, to form yes no questions, we place the helping verb before the subject. When we form yes no question, we place helping verb before the subject. Here you can see in example. Here you is subject and do is helping verb. The helping verb is used before you. Now, imperative sentences. Imperative sentences make a command, an advice, or a request. Or we can say imperative sentences RAO. Request, advice, or order. They usually start with a verb and may end with either an exclamation mark or a full stop. They generally start with a verb. An imperative sentence starts with a verb and ends with either exclamation mark or full stop. Here you say, don't do that. It is a command, exclamation mark. Please keep quiet, request, full stop. Eat healthy, advice, full stop. Exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentences express sudden and strong emotion. They end with an exclamation mark. For example, what a lovely place this is. What a beautiful day. Exclamatory sentence generally begins with what or how. Now, on the basis of use, there are three kinds of sentence. Type of sentence structure, there are three kinds. Simple sentence, compound sentence, and complex sentence. Simple sentence made of one independent clause that makes complete sense. Simple sentence is made of one independent clause, only one finite verb is there, and that makes complete sense. Here example, Adil plays football match. Here you see only one finite verb, plays, only one finite verb, so it is simple sentence. Compound sentence made of two or more independent clauses that are joined by a conjunction. Compound sentence is made of two or more independent clauses, main clauses, free clauses, and that are joined by a conjunction. Conjunction like and, or, but, etc. are used. For example, he has fever but he has accepted to play the match. He has fever, one independent clause. He has accepted to play the match, another independent clause. Both the independent clauses are connected with but. So, this is the example of compound sentence. Now, complex sentence. Made of an independent clause with X as the principal clause with one or more dependent clause. Complex sentence is made up of one independent clause with one or more dependent clause, subordinate clause. Example, the sun is so bright that we cannot gaze at it. Now, example is, you see, the sun is so bright is independent clause, we cannot gaze at it is subordinate clause. Here we see that one clause is depend on another clause. The such sentence is complex sentence. In compound sentence, you see both the clauses are independent clause. In complex sentence, one is independent, another is dependent. This is the difference. Today we have learnt kinds of sentences. I hope all of you have understood it. Thanks.